He's bad, bad, oh so bad, bad little you are.
Fish sticks. Huh? Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck me. Halloween again! Oh, what to review? It's gotta be something Halloween-y.
Oh.
Oh, God! Oh, I'd eat all those bean burritos! Oh, God! Ooh, the pain! Tearing me up inside! Huh? What's this? Oh. What's this in my pooper? Oh. Michael Myers! No! Ah! Oh, not again! Not Michael Myers! I guess it's nice to review a good movie for once. John Carpenter's Halloween. What's it about? You probably already know, but if you don't, here we go. The movie mainly takes place on Halloween night. The beginning of it shot in a POV style and adds a really creepy effect to the film. We follow young Michael around as he stalks his bigger sister and her boyfriend that are about to investigate each other's fuck parts. Incesty. So Mike goes into the kitchen and grabs a knife. By the time he makes it up to the stairs, the boyfriend is already leaving. Wow, that guy just came in like 25 seconds, maybe 20? What a limp dick. Fuck. Mike picks up a clown mask from the Dark Knight. Oh yeah, some titties. Gotta love that. Then Michael just unloads on that bitch. Yeah, stab that slut. Stab her! That's what you get when you spill paint in the garage.
Oh boy.
Anyway, the movie jumps ahead about 15 years later, and we meet Dr. Samuel Loomis, a name borrowed right out of Psycho, played by the late Donald Pleasance. He and his nurse are driving to Smith Grove Sanitarium to bring Michael to a court hearing. Something about little boys, I don't know. So when they arrive, they discover a bunch of people outside wearing white sheets. Then Michael attacks. What a dumb bitch. Just, you know, drive away. What are you doing? What? You're just gonna get out of your car? You're a fucking moron. Oh, that was stupid. I mean, they could have easily just drove away. Jumping ahead, we meet the lovable Laurie Strode, played by the woman who sells constipation yogurt, or some shit. She stops by the Myers house, and we see a figure in the doorway. Creepy. Throughout the day, Michael keeps reappearing to Laurie like a reoccurring herpes sore. Fate never changes. Yes, it doesn't. Michael also likes to stalk little boys in his station. Just can't give up the little boys, can you, Mike? While checking out some Latino sex lines, Dr. Loomis discovers a guy naked and dead. Probably brutally raped by Michael Myers. They never said that element, but we all knew it. Probably in a remake one of these days, they'll imply it. Kind of like in Nightmare on Elm Street, where we found out he was a child molester. Michael Myers is a rapist. Michael just keeps popping up, hiding in bushes and shit. Yeah. Behind clotheslines. Man, is he gonna kill this bitch good? Keep her labia as a trophy? Fuck Jamie Lee Curtis. Later on, Dr. Loomis goes to visit the grave of Judith Myers, but discovered it's missing, just like his hairline.
He came home.
Time for some dope smoking. How can someone who sells yogurt that cleanses your bowels smoke pot? Not cool, dude. So where's this movie going? Where's the plot? Well, it's Halloween, and Lori has to babysit a boy named Tommy Doyle, while Annie babysits a girl named Lindsay Wallace across the street from the Doyle house. And of course, Michael is lurking about like a creeper he is. Dr. Loomis and the sheriff chill out in the Myers house and decide to hunt Michael by themselves. And to go out and get some hookers when this is all said and done and lube up their cocks with Activia! Activia! Michael continues to stalk Annie. Man, is he a fucking weirdo? Is he jerking off or something? What a sick bitch. Michael kills their dog, Lester. I just said dog, Lester. Yeah, I bet Michael is a dog, Lester. Fuck. So any more bowel-regulating yogurts I should refer to? No. Anyway, like a little bitch, Annie drops Lindsay off with Lori so she can get 10 inches of dangerous paw dong. Too bad she'll never taste it because Michael's waiting in the back seat. She sure is submissive. I bet that's not the only time she's been choked, if you know what I mean. Uh-oh, Tommy notices Michael carrying the body of Annie, but he's just a stupid kid. Who's gonna believe him? I'm not. Oh, anyway. Linda and Bob totally show up, unaware that Michael Myers is in the house, cooking up some dog meat. Totally. Then these two go at it like a cat in heat. If only they knew Michael was watching them, stroking it in his William Shatner mask. Bob goes to get a beer, but that's not all he gets. Yeah, he gets a blade through the chest. I never understood this death scene. How is that one knife holding this guy to the wall? Whatever. Time for Linda to meet her maker. Yeah, Michael dresses up like a ghost and just stands there forever.
Cute, Bob. Real cute.
Fucking do something. Well, at least we get to see titties. At least. Linda decides to call Lori and see if Activia really works on constipation, but oh fuck, Michael strangles her to death. What's up with him strangling and choking people? Is that all he does? Concerned about her loser friends, Lori heads across the street, unaware of the danger waiting for her. Ah, yes, the final showdown between good and evil, right and wrong, hero versus villain, as old as the crucifixion. She makes her way upstairs to the bedroom with the light on. Oh shit, I'm getting so scared. Oh, she opens the door, discovering Judith Myers' tombstone above Annie's body. Oh, fuck. Oh, what do you want on your tombstone? Lori finally comes face to face with Michael. He slashes her, sending her flying over the rail. And we see the most classic shots in horror movie history. Oh, man. You can't beat that with a hooker's hand. Yeah, the chase is on. The fucking chase is on. I can't believe it. Oh, God, I'm on the edge of my seat. Oh, boy. Oh, she finally breaks a window and gets outside, luring Michael back to her and the kids. Oh, that's not very safe, you fucking dumb bitch. Luckily, Tommy lets her inside, just like Linda let the whole town inside her pussy. And that's why it reeks pretty bad. Stinky. Douche it. Oh, but it's not over. Not even close. Michael's inside that house already, quicker than a rapist enters your mom. She takes him down with a knitting needle. What? What? A knitting needle? Seriously? That's lame. This fucking badass killer's only weakness is a knitting needle? Huh. Cool. Lori checks on the kids, but you can't kill the boogeyman. No fucking way. Like a fucking moron, she hides in a paper-thin closet. People sure were dumb in the 70s. Fucking disco bastards. Somehow she uses her MacGyver skills and stabs Michael in the eye with a coat hanger. God, this guy is a pussy. He's taken down by sewing needles and coat hangers? Huh. Is he gonna slip on a banana peel and die? Maury sends the kids off, but oh fuck, it's still not over. It's never over. Yeah, he's still got some gas left in the tank. Time to choke this bitch once and for all. God, is he gonna choke everybody? Oh man. Maury rips off his mask and god damn is he an ugly fucker. No wonder he wears that mask. Put it back on, yeah. Luckily, Dr. Loomis unloads on his ass, sending him flying out the window. Is he dead? Is he? Well, they never die. The music rolls and there you have it. Halloween. Almost as scary as an old woman selling constipation relief yogurt. Actelia! I hope everyone has a fun Halloween.
What's the boogeyman?
As a matter of fact, it was.
Oh, is that all you got, you little bitch? Well, not Halloween 3. No! No! Dude, hey! Fuck.
I am a real American. Fight for the rights of every man. I'm a real American. Fight for what's right. Fight for your life.
I'm kind of busy right now.
Oh.